People, welcome to this tutorial. We are going to teach you how to fully use and manage AutoCAD 2014 in 3D projects. To understand all that it's explained here, make sure to know how to use this software in 2D projects first. Otherwise, have a look in the related video in this show. Let's suppose to start with a 2D project, here chosen at random. The first thing to learn is how to go from a 2D project to a 3D one. Go to the cube on the top right corner in your workspace and click on one of the vertices beside the top face you have. This will make you see your 2D project in 3 dimensions, which shows up flat and plate. You will see that the Z-axis appears in the Cartesian representation, so you are actually working in 3D. Instead of a simple cross, your pointer will have 3 segments on, which represent each direction of the Cartesian axis. Here the red one is the X-axis, the green one the Y one, and the blue one is the Z one. Drawing 2D objects in 3D visualization is very simple. Let's suppose to draw a solid with 2D objects only. If you need to follow the axis directions, you need to enable the Ortho mode at the bottom. This simply helps you to draw just lines that are parallel to the Cartesian axis. With a 2D base ready, use Line command to give height to the shape. Then press Escape and select such line. Hold Ctrl down and click on the central point. In this way you create copies of the same line itself. Once you have 4 of them, just use the Move command and put the 4 lines on each vertex. Then finish the 2D shape using a simple polyline on top. To manage this 3D shape altogether in the future, just create a group that contains all its objects, so that you can edit and move it. Assure that the group selection is always active. Of course, you will never do this to draw a 3D shape. We will see in a while how to do this easier. When you are watching your workspace in 3D, always remember that the X and the Y axis represent together the 2D space in AutoCAD. So, whenever you try drawing any 2D shape, these are put out of the Z axis and always on the X and the Y space defined area. The only 2D object that can be drawn in the third axis is the line command that we used to draw before in 3D. There are other exceptions, such as the 3D polyline, that can be extended through the Z direction as well, although you can create any curved line with these. This does value also for the most important 2D commands, such as the H one that fills objects that have boundaries totally on the XY space only. So, how do we get into 3D design? Go on top and right click on the black strip. Go to Show tabs and then click on 3D tools. This opens this new window right to manage 3D. You may have it closed by default. 3D tools is the window home but reported in 3D designs. The section modeling is used to create 3D objects. Some of them have curved surfaces, some others not. Keep in mind that the base, if the 3D object has any, is always drawn on the XY2D space. Heights are rendered through the third dimension, following the Z axis. When you draw this, especially the sphere, you can only see its simplified inner structure, made by simple lines. If you want to see better such 3D objects, go to View window and, in Visual Styles section, change the first option of the list. You can watch at 3D objects in many ways, with or without inner structure. For example, if you want to see 3D objects well and inner structure as well, you might choose X-ray. Below this first lot scene, you have other options to change further the way to see these objects, showing different lines or different renderings. Just try them out. You must keep in mind that the base is always on the XY area. In fact, whenever you want to draw, for example, a 3D object rotated 90 degrees, you don't have 3D rotation easily. You must rotate the Cartesian axis in order to draw 3D objects horizontally instead of vertically. To rotate such system, just select it and stare at the rounded point. This will rotate the workspace, but not the drawings inside. So draw according to this new 2D space and then come back to the original setting. Help yourself with the ortho mode if you want to rotate just 90 degrees or its multiples. Notice the difference between the 3D shape made by 2D objects and the 3D objects just drawn. For the first one, you actually don't have any true 3D space occupied. In the future, you will need to watch carefully at your project, or you want simply to change the point of view to draw better. You can use the cube in the top right corner as seen in the beginner tutorial. But for 3D designs, you don't have just the face top, you have also all the other faces. You can further click on the vertices and edges of the cube to watch at your project from hot angles according to axis directions. The orbit command on the extreme right lets you move the point of view with total freedom. Press then escape from your keyboard to exit from this action as always. Use it to check, for example, if solids drawn are all aligned. Zoom in and out using the mouse wheel. Let's see how to edit a 3D object. In each object with faces and curved surfaces, you always find squared points and blue triangles when it is being selected. The squared points appear when you have the intersection of two faces, and you can click on it and move it to change the sides of the two faces interested. The triangle ones instead rule the extension of the object through the direction indicated by such triangle. So you can stretch or shorten faces through it, or you can use it to change the radius of a pyramid space or a sphere. But in this case, differently from the 2D world, the kind of shape does stay the same. A pyramid stays a pyramid, a sphere a sphere. Whenever you use 3D visual styles, so any visual style except the 2D wireframe one, you will see a Cartesian system appearing when selecting any object, 2D or 3D. Click and drag one of the three colored arrows to move the object through the three directions, which correspond to the ones you have on the Cartesian axis you have on your workspace, where each color represents a direction that you can check. In parallel with 2D projects, where you add the polyline, here you have the polysolid. The polysolid lets you draw a general solid which is not regular. While you draw it, its height is fixed, so you actually draw on the XY2D space. You can change the starting height using the command line. Digit H while drawing and set the value you want. Then press Enter and go on with the drawing. When you want to close your polysolid, just digit C and then press Enter. Polysolids can be edited like normal 3D objects, although you have some extra editing points right in the space where you closed the polysolid first. These are used to change completely the polysolid in shape, extrusion and thickness in any direction. Enlarge the extrusion to manage these points better. Then start editing your polysolid completely. Differently from the polylines, the polysolids can have curved surfaces only while drawing and not after, unless you use more advanced commands we won't see. So while drawing, press A and then Enter from your keyboard whenever you want to add a curved space of solid, and then press L and Enter whenever you want to come back drawing straight blocks. There are then other ways to create 3D objects. Another way is to convert 2D objects to 3D ones. Let's see the most important conversions. Let's imagine to create a 3D shape starting from a 2D base, like at the beginning of this video. Go to Extrude and select such a 2D object. After pressing Enter, you will see that the 3D is made simply by adding a vertical extrusion 2D object, totally vertical. Similar is the Revolve command, which adds to a 2D base object 3D extrusion, but not straight through the Z direction, but changing angles according to the axis direction you can choose through the command line. There is also the sweep and the loft command, but these are a little more complex. Just try them on your own when you have experience. You can edit your 3D objects further using the Modify section in Home window, the same one you used for 2D shapes. But mind that some of these do act just through the XY2D space, like the Rotate command. Some others do work fully on all the three directions. For example, Move lets you move on two directions always, but such directions do depend on your point of view used. You can edit your 3D objects in a more advanced level in the 3D window, under Solid Editing section. Press Pull simply pulls up a surface, giving height to it according to its base. This does work on 2D faces, and so on 2D flat objects as well. Slice is used to divide an object in two parts. For example, to slice a 3D object according to a plane, you need to define two points in the space, which must be points belonging to objects, 2D ones or 3D ones, but existing. When you press Enter, the 3D object selected will be sliced into two different 3D objects through the direction defined by the plane that is identified through the two points chosen. Other editing commands are the Fillet and Chamfer Edge. These edit the edge of a 3D object that you can directly select, one or more of them. Depending on what you choose, chamfer and fillet, you will change such edge through a triangle point, giving it a more complex shape. Then you have the commands that operate on two or more 3D objects. Let's suppose to have two 3D objects that do interfere each other. They are solid, but you can still make overlappings with them, so that one is inside another. So, to check better this, you can use the Interfere command. The first selection is used to choose which are the objects to check, and then the second one to select the objects that you think that interfere. When you press Enter, the software will show you the intersection between the two selections made in red color. You have then the three commands on the right of Solid Editing section. Use Union to make a single unified 3D object with all the objects you selected while doing this command. Subtract is used to remove from the first selected object the volume that is occupied by the second object that you selected. This obviously has effects if the two objects do interfere. Use Intersect instead to get just the volume that is in common with all the objects that you have selected altogether. In 3D you have also the surfaces. These are 2D objects but treated and modifiable like 3D objects. In 3D Tools, the Surfaces section has all for this. Click on the second icon on the right to draw a plane surface. And remember that such will be always parallel with the XY2D area. You will need to rotate the Cartesian system to draw with different angles. Then you can use the other buttons to edit them properly. Make sure to leave the pointer on buttons for some time. The info window that appears will make you watch a very useful video that explains you what such commands do and how to use them. There are many and many more options to work with the 3D objects, a bit more advanced, For example, you can work with faces only, create offsets and others. Moreover, you have the mesh commands, which are used to create and manage objects, divided in many regular parts. You will learn these commands with experience, when a more complex project will make you use them. That's all for now. Follow us in the next video to know how to fill 3D objects and how to make a full render of them. Thanks for watching!